Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. Today I'm walking you through how to create double exposure effects using Adobe Express. This is an updated video of an older one that I've done and I thought it was time to do that. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I am at the home screen of Adobe Express and I'll start by clicking on the blue plus sign here on the top left corner and I'll start with a square project. You can choose any size you want. Now what I'm going to do is drag in an image that I'm going to use for this double exposure. Now, one thing I can do is choose media and upload here, but you could also drag your image. I'm going to go ahead and do that from my desktop here. Also, I'll go ahead and drag an image over and drop it right in here. There we have a photo. My colleague Rebecca took this picture of me last year. And so what I'm going to do here is resize this to fit into the canvas or the space here. So perfect right there. And then what I'll do is remove the background. We're gonna go ahead and let the AI run the magic background there remover, or I should say the remove background, to let the magic happen. There we go, that's what I wanted to say. All right, so I've got my picture and then what I'm going to do is make some adjustments to my picture. You could leave it in color. I like doing the desaturation of the image because I want to focus the color on the double exposure, the other image that I bring in. So I'll do a couple of things. I'll fix the highlights here and the brightness, maybe just a tad bit up. And then the contrast, if I go super contrasty, we can tweak it further once we bring the other image, which, speaking of the other image, let's go ahead and go to media. And I want to highlight what's here in the photos menu. There are so many stock images. These are all from Adobe stock. And what I'm going to do is find sunset or sunrise. In this case, I'll choose sunset. And I want to find something very colorful. So I'm going to go ahead and like this one right here looks gray. And let's just scroll down just a tad bit. I want to find something similar to that. And I may just go with that one. Let's see. I think I'm just going to go ahead and choose that one at the top, because I like the colors there. It's got some purples, reds, orange, blue. And we're gonna just make that larger here. So basically cover up the entire canvas, and I am covering up my image. And so we'll do it right about there. And here's where the magic happens. We're gonna choose the blend option. I love that Adobe Express, all the menus are now on the left. So that keeps that space on the right pretty empty. And then we have these blended modes. You got normal, multiply, and then the screen. We're going to choose screen, and there we have it. The magic has just happened, and we can move this up or down. So what I'm going to do is actually go back to my image because it's a little too contrasty. So I'm going to bring that down. There we go. Bring down the contrast, maybe the brightness up a little bit, or let's see, right about there. And then we'll play with the adjustments for the image that I just brought in. And I want that saturation to really be highlighted. So I want to see those colors in there. Yeah, there we go. And let's see what happens if we do the shadows, bring the shadows down a bit, maybe bring the brightness down a bit so we can see more of those colors. Again, this is preference. When you get to this point, you can tweak it and play around with it. That looks actually pretty cool. And I'm pretty happy with that. I'm gonna do one more thing here. I'm going to keep this project and then click on the button up here, view all pages. And I'm going to duplicate this because I wanna show you another version of this. I'll keep the original intact and I will double click this one. And we're going to click on the image that I brought in and we're going to replace it. So we'll use the replace option here. And I'm going to type in a dead tree here. And we're gonna try to pick a tree that is somewhat full, obviously no leaves. And we're gonna kind of create an effect here. So I think I'm gonna go with this one right here. That is pretty much what I want to do. Perfect. So then what I'll do is tweak this a bit, make it a little bit smaller. And there we go. And the reason I wanna use this tree, the dead tree, is kind of creates an effect where it doesn't fill in my entire image, but I can see my face there. That actually looks kind of cool right about there. And if I want to see more of my face, I can just adjust that. But this is the whole point of this, is to kind of have that somewhat not complete, almost like a nervous system there. Kind of cool. And then again, the image just took on the adjustments that I had before. So you can desaturate that, make it all black and white and so on, which I think I kind of like that. And that's how to create double exposure effects using Adobe Express. So now it's your turn to give it a try. If you have any comments or questions about the video, feel free to drop it in the chat. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video. And as always, have fun creating. Peace.